Hello all, welcome to the YouTube live session on conic sections. So in this class, we'll be continuing with the ellipse which we had left the previous class. So I'll start today's concept with the concept of pole and polar in case of an ellipse. Okay. So let me first load in a graph for an ellipse over here. Okay. Yeah. So what is a pole and a polar concept? So let P be any point inside or outside an ellipse. Okay. It can be even on the ellipse. Let's say there's a point P inside the ellipse. And through this point P, you are drawing many chords. Okay, so let's say I draw this chord through this, and again I draw another chord like this. Okay, so I can keep on drawing so many chords, and now through the extremities of these chords, let me draw tangents. Okay, so let's say these are the two tangents which I draw at the extremities of these chords. Yeah, so these tangents, they will meet on a line which we call as the polar. So as you can see, they meet on this line, and this line is called the polar of this pole. So this point is called the pole. Okay. And also remember, this pole could be inside the ellipse as well. The pole could be pole could be outside the ellipse as well. Okay. Now the equation of the pole, equation of the polar with respect to a given pole x1, y1. So equation of the polar with respect to an ellipse for pole x1, y1. Is again given by t equal to 0. Okay, that means if x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1 is the ellipse, then the equation of the polar would be this. So this would become the equation of the polar. So as I told you earlier, t equal to 0 can behave as many things. It behaves as a tangent when the x1, y1 point is on the ellipse. It behaves as polar. So I'll write it down over here. It behaves as tangent when x1, y1 is on the ellipse. Okay. It's not that it is not polar in this case. It can also be called as a polar in this case. So tangent is the polar of the point of contact. So t equal to 0 can also behave as chord of contact. Now this is also a type of a polar when the pole is outside. And when t equal to 0 purely behaves as a polar, when the point is inside, when x1, y1 is inside, right? So let us take some questions based on pole and polar. First question is, find the polar of the focus, or you can say find the polar of a focus of an ellipse. Very simple question. You should all be able to answer this. So I'm asking you, if pole is the focus, If pole is your focus, then what is the polar? And please feel free to type in your response in the chat box. How was your practical, guys, today? All right, so pretty simple. So again, let's say this is the equation of the ellipse and we are trying to find out the polar of the focus. So focus is at, let's say, A, comma, 0. So T equal to 0. So first of all, this is the expression for T. And here we'll be putting our X1 as A and Y as 0. So it becomes X equal to A by E. Right? And this is nothing but the directrix. This is nothing but the directrix of the ellipse. So just remember this as a theorem that polar of the focus is nothing but the directrix. Polar of the focus in case of an ellipse is nothing but the directrix of the ellipse. All right. So let's move on to another question. Next question is, the perpendicular from the center of an ellipse x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1 on the polar of a point is constant. Prove that the locus of the point is x square by a to the power 4 plus y square by b to the power 4 equal to 1 by c square. Where c is the given constant over here. So this constant over here is your c. If you're done, guys, you can also send me the snapshot on my WhatsApp ID. All right, this says, let's assume that the point is h comma k, right? So the equation of the polar will be t equal to 0, which is nothing but xh by a square plus yk by b square equal to 1. Now the distance of the origin, that's the center of the ellipse, from this polar is a constant c. So I can clearly write it as, first of all, I can just rephrase it as this equal to 0 and put 0, 0 in place of x and y. So it will be mod of minus 1 by under root of h by a square whole square k by b square whole square equal to c. That means 1 by c is under root of s square by a to the power 4. K square by b to the power 4, so which becomes 1 by c square, h square by a to the power 4, k square by b to the power 4. And you can always generalize this. You can always generalize this as x square by a to the power 4 plus y square by b to the power 4 equal to 1 by c square, and hence proved. Right? Again, be very, very careful with locus type questions because they're very, very important. Let me take one more. CD is a variable chord of the ellipse. X square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1. Always subtending 90 degrees at the center. Always subtending 90 degrees at the center. Show that the locus of the pole of CD. Show that the locus of the pole of CD with respect to that ellipse is x square by a to the power 4 plus y square by b to the power 4 equal to 1 by a square plus 1 by b square. So basically the question says there is an ellipse. Okay. And there is a variable chord. That subtends a right angle at the center. Okay, that subtends a right angle at the center. All right. Now we have to find out the locus of the pole of CD. Okay. So let us say the pole of CD was, let's say, H, K point. Okay. Now, the equation of CD now will be, XH by A square plus YK by B square equal to 1. Okay. Right. Now, if I have to find out the combined equation of OC and OD, that means if I have to find out the equation of the pair of lines OC and OD, right? How will I find that out? I can find it out by homogenizing. I can find it out by homogenizing the equation of CD with the ellipse equation. So how do we homogenize? Remember the concept, when a line and a conic section gets intersected, the pair of straight lines joining origin to the point of intersection is obtained by homogenizing the equation of the line with the conic section. So when I say homogenizing, do not disturb the second degree terms of the conic. But this one term, this one over here, you can actually write it as XH by A square plus YK by B square whole square. Okay, because one is this, and you can write that one as one square. So from this equation, you can write X square by A square plus Y square by B square equal to XH by A square plus YK by B square whole square. Now, you know it's 90 degree. That means it represents a pair of straight lines which subtends a 90 degree at the origin. That can only happen if the sum of the coefficients, let me call this as one, sum of the coefficients of x square and y square in 1 add to 0. Okay, so what is the coefficient of x square? Coefficient of x square will be this. What is the coefficient of y square? The coefficient of y square will be this. And if this adds to 0, that would be the condition for the two lines represented by OC and OD to be at 90 degrees to each other. So if you write it in a resolved form, you'll find that it actually comes out as the required locus. So if you generalize this, it becomes x square by a to the power 4 plus y square by b to the power 4 equal to 1 by a square plus 1 by b square. And I think this is what we are supposed to prove. As you can see, yes, this is what we are supposed to prove over here. Right? Is this clear, guys? Any questions, please feel free to ask. So the next concept that we are going to talk about is the concept of diameter. Now, first of all, how is the diameter defined? Diameter is basically focus of the midpoints of system of parallel chords. Focus of The midpoints of a system of parallel chords is called the diameter. Okay. So basically, let's say if this is your ellipse, okay, and you draw a system of parallel chords like this, okay, and start connecting their midpoints, and start connecting their midpoints, then this line that you see will be called, the white line that you see will be called as the diameter. So this line will be called as the diameter. Now let me ask this as a direct question to you. Find the equation of the diameter that bisects a system of parallel chords with a slope of m. So let's say we have our standard case of an ellipse. And all these chords, they have the slope of mm each. Okay. Then find the equation of the diameter. Then find the equation of the diameter. So that's the question. Again, feel free to type in your response in the chat box. Or send me a pic on the WhatsApp. Okay, it's not important to know the concept of diameter per se, but how do you actually solve it as a locus question is what is important. Again, I'm repeating, the concept of locus is what I'm more interested in testing. Probably IIT will never ask you a question on diameter, but this is like a building block for you to understand locus very well. So the answer should be in terms of course, the variables x and y and a, b and m only. We don't have to assume that that will actually be evident from the equation only. All right, so let's see this case. Again, let's say h, k, whose locus we are finding. Okay, so h, k is the midpoint of a chord. So what is the equation of that chord? If h, k is the midpoint of a chord, what is the equation of that chord? Simple question. The equation of that chord is t equal to s1. Right? So t equal to s1. Correct? So this is the equation of the chord. Now this chord is having a slope of m. This chord is having a slope of m. Right? So let us write down the expression for the slope of this. Slope of this will be minus h by a square divided by k by b square. So this will be your slope, right? And that's it. That's what we wanted. We wanted a relationship between h and k, right? So now we generalize this. Now we generalize this and we write m as minus b square x by a square y. In other words, y is equal to minus b square x by a square y, sorry, a square m. This becomes the equation of the diameter. And as you can see, Atmesh, it passes through origin. So yes, it passes through the center of the ellipse. It passes through the center of the ellipse. Okay, plain and simple.